Since September 11th, law enforcement agencies, large and small, have been doing what they can to prevent similar tragedies using techniques such as aerial surveillance. But helicopters, which work very well for that, can be expensive and also tricky to fly sometimes. Enter an airplane from aviation's past. Special correspondent Pat Woodard takes us now on a test flight in the gyroplane.
Every morning, a small airport west of Phoenix begins to stir with the rollout of a mystery aircraft.
Okay, yeah, let's go do this one. This is 6-1-069. I'm the pilot flying and pilot in command.
For a test pilot, an aircraft with just 3 hours of flight time is cause for caution.
This will be interesting.
Yeah.
Once the engine starts, you begin to wonder just how this thing will fly at all. It looks like a helicopter with an airplane propeller or an airplane with a helicopter rotor. Wings? Forget about them.
A gyroplane is an official FAA designation for an aircraft that has an unpowered rotor in flight.
The gyroplane concept has been around for nearly a century. The power comes from a propeller. The function of the rotor is to act as a wing, with only the wind keeping the blades turning after takeoff.
The primary advantage, and there are several, but the primary advantage is lack of complexity. There's no load-bearing transmission as there is in a helicopter. There's no tail rotor or tail rotor gearbox or tail rotor drive shaft and several hundred other components.
With so few working parts, a gyroplane costs about half as much to maintain as a helicopter.
I'll do a quick run-up and check the systems.
In a way, the idea here is to bring back the early days of aviation. It's been 50 years since gyroplanes had any meaningful role in aviation, but the people trying to change that believe there are markets for this aircraft with applications ranging from agriculture to law enforcement.
Now that the blades are fully engaged, I'm going to slowly spin the throttle up, and that's going to increase our rotor RPM.
The rotor is powered only in the moments before takeoff, which requires that much runway.
One of the great things about the gyroplane is just like the helicopter, it certainly does not require an airport. Takeoff and landing is different than an airplane and a helicopter. But like with most flying machines, once you're in the air, it's all basically the same.
In the 1920s and 30s, gyroplanes were relatively common. With their ability to take off from rooftops, they enjoyed a brief heyday. About the only thing they couldn't do was hover, which is what nearly killed them off just before World War II.
At the end of the 30s, all aviation programs, and I say again, all aviation programs were funded by the military. The military required hovering. And so the helicopter became the project that was funded by the military.
The gyroplane may not be able to hover, but it can come close.
There's 45. There's 40. And you can see we're not descending at all, but we're slowed down greatly. At this altitude, it's almost like we're not even moving.
An airplane flying low and slow has a tendency to stall. And when a helicopter's engine quits, the pilot has a short time to put his craft into what's called an auto-rotation, getting the rotor spinning again in time for a safe landing.
One of the great things about gyroplanes is that we're always in auto-rotation. We're already auto-rotating right now. So if the engine were to fail, it's almost just like a normal landing. We select our landing site. The pilot doesn't have to make any special maneuvers or motions of the controls. He picks his landing site and just heads towards it and basically performs a normal landing.
This flight will test one possible application for a gyroplane.
The aircraft is designed to be a half-scale model of a freight-carrying aircraft that will carry about 2 tons of freight to places that you can't otherwise get into.
It looks good. It looks good. It looks like we might have increased a little speed there.
The developers of the modern gyroplane know it will be a challenge to sell industry on an aircraft that's been relegated to aviation's attic.
Many people, before they see the aircraft or ride in the aircraft, use that exact phrase. It was not a commercial success in the 30s. Why should it be a commercial success now?
Scott Tennyson may be the best answer to that question. He's an experienced helicopter pilot. At least he was until he flew a gyroplane. Now he's convinced that aviation may be ready to take a step forward by taking a step back.
That was fun, wasn't it? Yeah, this is a great aircraft.
Gyroplanes started flying high again in the late 1980s, and just recently one of them flew security patrols during the 2002 Winter Olympics in Salt Lake City.